Hi everybody, my name is Blue Phoenix, but some people call me Eric. This will be my first video here on this new channel about asexuality and aromanticism. And I figured for my first video, I'd just dive right on in and talk about asexuality. It's a beautiful day out here in Kentucky. It's still winter time, but it's freakishly warm, so I decided to just go ahead and record out here. So anyway, there's two brief definitions for asexuality. The first one would be the official AVEN definition, which says an asexual person is a person that does not experience sexual attraction. There's also another definition that's been floating around on the forums that I think makes a lot more sense, which is an asexual person is a person that has no innate desire for partnered sex. So let me talk briefly about the first definition. It's kind of iffy because if you've never experienced sexual attraction in your life, then it's very difficult to understand what it is exactly you're missing out on. So one analogy I'm thinking of is like if you had no sweet taste buds, let's say your whole life you never could understand the flavor of sweetness and sugar, which would be really sad. So everybody's telling you like how awesome like ice cream and cake is, and they just love eating cake, but you go and you eat the cake, maybe if it's like chocolate cake, it just kind of tastes bitter to you, and you just never really understood it. But you know, everybody's going around eating cake and you're like, well, I guess I'm supposed to like cake, so yeah, I'll just tell people I love cake and all that. So asexuality is kind of like that. It's like you're just missing this thing that everybody else around you experiences, and it's just something that you don't really quite understand. And if somebody was trying to describe sweetness to you when you had never in your life experienced sweetness, it might not make a lot of sense. I mean, you can kind of go secondary, like, yeah, you eat something sweet and it makes you happy and it puts a smile on your face. But as far as describing the actual flavor of sweetness, that would be very difficult to do. So there's the second definition around desire. We can break this down into smaller parts. I mean, desire itself is just this kind of pull to perform some kind of an action or acquire some object or perhaps to eat some kind of food. Maybe you got a hankering for sushi or something. So if you're kind of put in this position where you can obtain this action or this item, you would just go ahead and do it. You know, if there were no repercussions, you would just go ahead and jump right in. That's desire. So then partnered sex, of course, refers to sex with other people, which excludes doing it yourself or masturbation. So also the word innate means that the desire has to come from within yourself. So it's you're not doing it because of external reasons. So there's no ulterior motives for that desire. It's just coming from within. So, for example, an asexual could desire sex in order to please their partner if they were in a romantic relationship, or maybe just to reproduce. They want to have a child, and they want to be genetically theirs. They might go through with the act of sex, even though they don't desire it. So in that case, it's not really an innate desire. So you take those exterior motives away, those external factors, and an asexual would just have no problem at all with not having sex. They wouldn't miss it. They wouldn't go looking for it. It just wouldn't be there. Okay? An asexual person is a person that has no innate desire for partnered sex. Or asexuality is the lack of innate desire for partnered sex. That's basically it. There's really nothing more to it and nothing less. Of course, you can delve into that meaning, that definition, quite a bit more, and there's shades of gray, but if we're just talking about pure asexuality, that's it. So there's a lot of misconceptions that might mislead you to believe you're not asexual, and I fell into a lot of these traps myself, so that's why it took me so long, at the age of 37, to finally figure this out for myself. So one misconception is that asexuals do not masturbate. But according to a survey on AVEN, about 80% of them do, actually. So it's more about just kind of relieving that sexual tension, and they feel fine just doing that on their own. They don't need somebody else to feel fulfilled in doing that. An analogy to that would be like, let's say everybody around you, this was perfectly normal, that everybody liked to quench their thirst with a milkshake, okay? So, for whatever reason, people just love, when they get thirsty, they're like, I really want a milkshake bad. But for you, it was always, you know, water was enough. Same kind of thing, okay? The other misconception is that asexuals do not desire romantic relationships. That's actually only true of about 20% of asexuals. That is called aromanticism. It's kind of a separate topic. I'm not going to talk about that much right now, but the other 80% of asexuals do desire romantic relationships, and they can fulfill that either in a mixed relationship with another, with a sexual person, or with an asexual person. Okay, another misconception is that asexuals have no sexual arousal. That's also not true. That's kind of just a physical reflex. It's an autonomic response. As long as it doesn't lead to the desire for partnered sex, you can still be asexual and have sexual arousal, physical arousal. And lastly, another misconception is that asexuals don't like looking at beautiful people, which is not true. You can actually enjoy the sight of somebody, maybe the same gender or opposite gender, and you enjoy looking at them, but if that doesn't lead to the desire for sex, then you're not experiencing a sexual attraction. What you're probably experiencing is aesthetic attraction, which is just kind of this draw to look at something that's beautiful or someone that's beautiful. So that's basically like Asexuality 101, and hopefully you got something out of that. I'll try to do more videos, obviously, on this channel, and hopefully you'll subscribe, and I'll catch you around on the next time.